So I heard this quote last night. I'm gonna do my best not to butcher it. And it, really got me thinking. And it basically went something like, only a fool doesn't think about the downside, but it's a coward that lets that stop him from doing what he knows he needs to do. And I was thinking about it because I don't know really whether it's my sort of accountant's mind or if I was just sort of born with this inherent sort of pessimism, but I always look at the downside. I always look at, okay, what could be lost? Like, how could this go wrong? How could I lose? What would be the worst thing? Like, for example, whenever I get into an apartment, I always think about it, like, if I'm gonna pay a certain amount a month, right? Let's say $5,000 a month or whatever the case may be, if you're gonna get into an apartment, I'm always thinking about, okay, well, what if I need to leave early? How much do I need to pay to get out of this lease? So let's say you pay first month, last month deposit, right, 15,000, and but if you leave, you get a 2 month penalty. But you already paid, the deposit, and you already paid the last month, so they take that. So really, you don't have to pay anything. So I always think about it that way. I always think, what would be the downside? But it wasn't really until that quote, and I mean, literally last night, where I became aware that that kind of other side of it is, yeah, it's important to look at the downside, and that's kept me safe. It's like there's this other quote that I heard once, where it's like, look, just literally just don't lose money, right? I mean, and I think it was a Warren Buffett one, where it's like rule number one is don't lose money, rule number two is don't lose money. And because I have that thinking where I just always think of the downside, I'm not one of these people that's just ruthlessly optimistic. Like, I think things can't fail. I know things can fail, and I know things can go wrong, and I know that things will go wrong. But what I realized in that quote is that sometimes I let that from actually letting me sort of take a big risk, take a big chance. And it keeps me from committing because I could lose. It's like you could lose by taking the next step, whether that's investing in a biz investing in the business or moving or getting a new place or getting an office or whatever the case may be. And I feel this sort of sense of, oh my gosh, well, it could not work. I could end up in trouble. I could lose. I could make a mistake. And so it's sort of that balance. It's like, okay, am I a fool for not looking at the downside and being ruthlessly optimistic? Or am I a coward for just looking at what I could lose and not ever taking any risk? And so probably one of the biggest things I've learned from doing, pretty well in business is just that there's sort of a right time for everything. Like, I used to be this kind of guy where I sort of believed that things were a certain way. Like, yes, the world is a certain way, politics are a certain way, religion's a certain way, relationships are a certain way, and all this kind of thing. And I've sort of just been humbled literally so many times. Like, I've been proven wrong. Like, everything I used to think about religion, or everything I used to think about politics, or everything I used to think about business, basically all those things in my life have changed, I mean, at least, 6 or 7 times. And so the older I get and the more I learn about things, the more I realize that, yeah, I really don't know a lot, and I keep on being disproven, and things that I thought were true are totally not true. And so when I think about this quote of, are you a fool or are you a coward? I think sometimes, look, being on that side where you look at the downside is important, and just, just paying attention to that. It's like I met somebody recently who was just millions and millions and millions of dollars in debt, and they just would not ever look at the downside. Never look at the downside. Never think about, oh my gosh, this might not work. Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna be able to pull this off. Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna be able to pull pay this debt back. And they literally just could, you couldn't snap them out of it. There was nothing you could do. They were just ruthlessly optimistic to the point of their own demise. And then you have, the other type of people that, are just always looking at the downside and just super pessimistic, and oh, this person's, full of crap, and oh, the world's going to hell, and oh, I better buy some gold because the economy's gonna crash. I might have been like that at one point in my life, worried about this kind of stuff. And while those people are worried about these kinds of things, they're so worried about losing that they miss out on all the gains. But there is so much more to gain in life than there is to lose. And but at the same time, you want to keep that side of looking at the downside. So I love that quote because even though the person that said it didn't really think about it, I don't think in this way, but it was really one of those moments where it reminded me to look at both sides, and in some situations take one and in some situations take the other. But it's not like being optimistic is a good thing. But it's not like being pessimistic is a good thing. I mean, both of them are good and both of them are bad given the circumstances. So I hope this little video finds you well. Hope you guys are doing well out there. Keep crushing it, and we'll talk soon.